Hi everyone, thank you for joining us today for Keep Learning with KSPS. Today's lesson is for fourth graders, but anyone can join. My name is Amber Smith and I'm a fourth grade teacher here in Spokane Schools, and I'm really excited to get to work with you today. All right, we're going to start with a warm-up today of adding fractions together. And we're going to add some fractions together that don't have like denominators. So you may feel pretty comfortable with adding half to a half because the denominators are the same. And when we have that, we can just add across the tops. So we'd have 1 + 1 = 2, and then the denominator wouldn't change. But what do you do when you get something like 1/2 + 1/4? How do you do that? Well, some of these you can do with mental math, but some of them you also might need to change it into an equivalent fraction. So I want us to talk about that 1/2 and that 1/4 with a picture today. So let's start with the 1/2. And you're probably pretty familiar with a 1/2 being this much, right? And in comparison, if you have a fourth, you would draw fourths and it would look like that, right? So how do you know how many fourths are in a half? Well, one way you can think about this is we can actually take the model and we can split it like that to find the equivalent fraction. So we can find out that 2/4 is the same as 1/2. So now I'm just going to fix that and say, okay, 2/4. 1/2 + 1/4 is the same as 2/4 + 1/4. So then what do I get? I get 3/4. So I want you to be thinking about those halves. How many fourths is that? So getting that in your head. So let's try it with another one. Let's try it with 3/4 + 1/2. Can you mentally do that? Can you think about what that half can also represent? So if you're thinking, well, we've got 3/4, and we know from the prior one up here that 1/2 is the same as 2/4. There we go, right? So we'll add across the tops, and then the denominator stays in the fourths. Okay, how you doing so far with that? All right, let's look at another one. A little more challenging because we're going to put a whole number with it. And we're going to add in a half. So we have 1 1/4 and 1/2. So let's think about that. If you're struggling a little bit, you could always draw a little picture. So here's the half, right? Here's the 1 whole. And then we also have that 1/4. So how could you write that? Could you think of it as 1 1/4 + 2/4? What would that be? What do you do with that 1? Well, those whole numbers, they get to just stay. And then you put the fractions together. So 1/4 + 3/4 is the same as 1 2 3/4. So 1 3/4. All right, let's look at one more for a warm-up problem. 1 3/4 + 2 1/2. 1 3/4 + 2 1/2. So my first step is, let's get those whole numbers together. So let's put these guys together. So 1 + 2 = 3. And then I've got to deal with this 3/4 and this 1/2. I'm going to turn that 1/2 into some fourths just by splitting it. And so how many do I have now? I've got 1 2 3 4 5/4. That looks a little strange, doesn't it? What can you do with the 5/4? I'm thinking, well, I know there's a 4/4 in there. And I know there's a 1/4 in there because 4 + 1 = 5. I can even think about that here. If I have this These fourths, that's 4/4, right? With one left over. So I could actually add this into that, right? So I would end up with 4 1/4 as my final. That one's a little tricky. You might need to look at that one again. All right, so just remembering that when you're adding fractions together or subtracting them, it's much easier if you can get them to have the same denominator or to be able to think about, like, what's the equivalent fraction of that? I know 1/2 is 2/4. And you can mentally do them if you get pretty confident with that. So, all right, let's look at our lesson for today. So we're changing improper fractions into mixed numbers. And we need to review a little bit of vocabulary before we jump into this lesson. So the first thing I want to talk to you about is those two words, numerator and denominator. So if I have a fraction like 3/4, the top number, when we're talking about it, is called the numerator, and the bottom number is called the denominator. And the word fraction is referring to this whole piece here. So 3/4 is a fraction. It's part of a whole number. Two big vocab words for today, improper fraction and mixed number. Improper fraction is when we have a fraction, so the numerator is bigger than the denominator in an improper fraction. If we're talking about a mixed number, if I had a whole number and a fraction next to it, so that's what that means. So this is a mixed number when I have a whole number and a fraction together, and this is an improper fraction when the numerator is bigger than the denominator. So what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be taking improper fractions and we're going to be turning them into mixed numbers. And the reason we do that is just to make it easier to work with and to think about when we're working with fractions. So let's start with 15/4. And I'm going to take you through using a picture model. So the first thing we need to talk about is whole numbers and how these fractions are broken up into fourths. So a whole unit would have 4 pieces. So it would have 4 pieces. So when we're drawing picture representations of these improper fractions, we want to make sure that our denominator, our bottom number, matches up with how many sections we have in our representation in our picture. So now if I color these in, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. I have 4/4. So this is 4/4, which is the same as one whole because we colored in the whole thing. But I need to get to 15/4. So we're going to have to draw another one. And we always have to split it up into fourths because that's what our denominator is saying. It's saying that these whole units are broken up into fourths. And that's another whole unit. So how many fourths do I have all together right now? We could count them. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I've got to get to 15. I'm not there yet. So let's draw another unit and let's color that in. So 9, 10, 11, 12, if I keep counting on, right? So I've got 12 so far, but I'm not at 15 yet. And we want to get to 15. So I stopped at 12 up here. So let's come over here. 13, 14, 15. So I'm going to write that in just to help us see that. 13, 14, 15/4. So what could you say about this picture representation? How many whole units did I shade in? Well, I can look at them and I can see, well, there's one hole. Everything's shaded in. There's 2 holes. There's 3 holes. So I have 3 whole units. And then over here, what is the fraction for that? I've shaded in 3 out of 4, so 3/4. So to turn this improper fraction into a mixed number, I can draw it as a picture, making sure I'm using my denominator to show how many pieces to break up my whole unit into. And then I can figure out by shading it in how much it is. And 15/4 is the same as 3 3/4. Now that's a little bit easier to think about than 15/4, because think about it like this. If these were chocolate bars that I shaded in, and if my friend said, well, how many chocolate bars do you have? And if I said I have 15/4, that would sound a little confusing, wouldn't it? But if I said, oh, I have 3 3/4, it makes a little more sense in my head. So that's one of the big reasons too why we want to get it into a mixed number. So the number just makes a little more sense. So let's practice it with another view here, and then I'll give you some to practice on your own that you can write down for today. So the next one we're going to look at is 13/5. So ask yourself, if I'm going to draw a whole unit, how many pieces do I need to cut that up into? So what do you remember from the other problem? So hopefully you're remembering that we have to use the denominator to help us know how many pieces to break this up into. So I'm going to break it up into 5 pieces. And I need 13 of those fifths. So let's start shading them in. So there's 1 2 3 4 5. I'm not at 13 yet, so I need to draw another one. There's another 5/5. And let's see, we're getting to 13. So I have 5 on this first one. 1 2 3 4 5. And let's see, 6 7 8 9 10. 6 7 8 9 10. I have 10/5 that I've shaded in so far. So I need to draw another bar. I'm going to draw it down here. All right. And I got up to 10 up here. So let's count on a little more. We have to get to 13. 11, 12, 13. So now I have 13 there. And we will label those to help you see it. All right, so what can you say about this? What would the mixed number be that would go with this improper fraction? So 13/5 is the same as what? How many whole units do you see? How many fractional pieces do you see that are left over? I see that I have one whole shaded in here. I have another whole, so I have 2 whole units shaded in. And then if I look here, what's my fraction? I see 3/5. So 1 whole, 2 wholes, 3/5. So my mixed number that is the same as that improper fraction is 2 3/5. On the next one, if you haven't been drawing along with me, I'd like you to draw along and let's figure out what we need to do. So I'm looking at the denominator, and it's going to tell me how many pieces each of my whole units has. So we're talking about fourths. I'm looking at my numerator, and my numerator is telling me how many I need to fill in. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Do you have an idea of how many we might have to draw? I'm going to draw another one, because so far I have 8 9 10 11 12. Not there yet. 13 14 15 16. Still got to get to 21. How many whole units do we have so far that we filled in? We have 4 whole units that we filled in. So 16, and I'm at 17, 18, 19, 20. Getting closer, I'm almost there. Just remember that I can't just draw this and shade it in. That's not correct. I have to make sure I draw the whole unit, right? And now let's see, let's double check it. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. How many whole units do I have? So I'm looking, how many of those bars are all the way shaded in? I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that are all the way shaded in. And then this last one here is 1/4. So my mixed number that's equivalent to that improper fraction is 5 1/4. So I'm hoping that you're seeing the pattern of how that you work through this problem. We're going to do it on one more, and then I'm going to show you one other quick trick that you can try. It's a little more advanced. So now we've got 27/6. This is when the bonus piece is going to be really important, because as you get bigger numbers in that numerator, it's a lot to draw. So you might get kind of tired of that. So I'm going to show you another way to do it too. So 27.6. So we've got a unit that is broken up into six this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm going to shade those in. So let's see, that's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How many do you think we're going to end up shading in? Like, how many whole units are we going to get? 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Do you have any strategies that you're using to figure that out quickly? How many do we have here? So that was 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. And we're almost there. 25, 26, 27. So how many whole units do you see where everything is shaded in? I see 1, 2, 3, 4. And how many fractional pieces do we have left? I see 3 out of 6. Okay. So that is the process for going from a improper fraction to a mixed number using pictures. There's one other way that you can do this, and it might make sense for you and it might not make sense for you, but watch and let's see what happens. So if I have 27 over 6, I'm really thinking about how many times will 6 go into 27. So how many times can 6 go into 27 and get me close to 27? I can't go over. So can you think of any math facts that get you there? So I'm thinking, well, I know 6 times 3 is 18. It's close, but I might be able to get closer. I know 6 times 4, that's 24. So goes in 4 times and is pretty close. I wonder if I can get even closer. My next one would be 6 times 5. That's 30. That goes over. That's too much, so I can't use that one. So I know 6 times 4 equals 24. How far away am I from 27? So if I had to count up from 24 to 27, how much more is that? I got 25, 26, 27. That's 3 more, right? Okay, so check this out. I know it'll go in 4 whole times. And then to get to 27, it's 3 more. 4 and 3, 6. Interesting, right? Matches up with our answer that we already got. So that is another little method that you can use in order to figure it out. You try to figure out how many times will the denominator go into the numerator, and then how much do I have left over that I didn't quite get there. Sometimes it divides perfectly into it. Sometimes it doesn't, and you have that little leftover, like that 3, 6. So be thinking about that. That's another way to do it if you want to get a little quicker and not use the picture model. All right. So the practice problems I have for you today, if you would write these down, and then think of a way that you could communicate it with your teacher. I have 17 fourths, so turning these into mixed numbers, 12 fifths, 14 thirds, and then 18 sixths. So I want you to write those down, and I want you to turn those improper fractions into mixed numbers and then communicate that with your teacher. Thank you for learning with me today, and I look forward to learning with you next time.